Happy Valentine's Day, baby, is what you should be saying to your significant other on Valentine's Day. But EA decided to tell us 2 weeks in advance with this rare players pack. I mean, these Ruby cards that have just been released, consider it ICE 2.0. 80 of the best players in the NHL received upgrades, some of which are pretty crazy. Tuukka Rask, 96 overall now. His highest card before the set, 87 overall. So a huge boost there. We're going to be checking out some of the cards that were released, and at the end of the video, you guys will see every card with synergies and overall. It also released a Jesse Poolparty flash forward and a Sam Gagner flashback to his one game hero performance back in the day. There are also some new cards that came out here. Pretty sure no one cares about him. McDavid, 90 overall. Okay, I guess that's kind of cool. Otherwise, nah. If you go into sets, the first thing you'll notice is these Ruby sets on the far left. You can trade in 4 gold collectibles for a random Ruby player item. Kind of risky because it's a random player and those players can be, well, on the low end, like 88, 89 overall, which don't go for anything. Excuse the way that I'm speaking right now, as I had a device placed in my mouth, so I sound like I'm eating all the time when I'm not. On the official EA Sports website, EA released an article talking about Ruby sets, which for some reason they didn't include anywhere else in the game. They said that there's going to be a new Ruby set every week that can be completed every 24 hours. Starting off, you have 1 times any Ruby player, February 2nd to February 6th. From February 6th to the 13th, we get a 90 plus overall player. After that's a 92 plus overall player. And then mystery Ruby sets up until March 13th.
I can't say March with this contraption in my mouth. I'm sorry.
I don't think this necessarily means that the players that they release will be stronger, but you'll just have a higher chance of getting better cards over time. Moving on to just some of the cards that have been released. Starting with the Anaheim Ducks, I wanted to mention that any new cards that were released through the Ruby cards, well, their evolution card counterparts got upgrades, such as this Getzlaf, 93 overall. His evolution card got a big boost. Let's take a look at some of the stats. Still a fairly slow card at 90 acceleration, 90 speed, but faceoffs, 94. That's really good. All these Ruby cards seem to have 3 synergy points, but no new synergies were added in the making of these cards. Raquel also got a bump up. Not too exciting unless you're an evolution card owner, which even then, I don't know if it went up by that much. Anaheim also gets a John Gibson, 89 overall with 3 synergy points. Arizona doesn't get much love, so we're going to skip him. Onto the Bruins, who get a lot of love. We talked about Tuukka, 96 overall. Marchand got an upgrade at 95 overall. Sadly, Bergeron's Ruby card is the same as his Team of the Week card, so he doesn't get an upgrade. We're going to have a card like Pasternak. We're going to have a card like Krug, which is nice, I think. In an upcoming video, we're going to talk about which Ruby cards you guys probably want to have on your team. We're going to build budget teams out of these Ruby cards, so stay tuned for that. On the side, we're also going to open up some packs, because we have some coins and some of those premium coins to spare. Starting with this rare players pack that they released. Why not open one? See what's inside, you know. Usually packs are really juiced when a bunch of new cards come out. And there was nothing in here. So we'll just pretend like we never opened that. So first pack, let's open it. See what's inside. I'm so excited because this is the first pack that I'm opening. I don't want my hopes and dreams to die. We get an 88 overall Mitch Marner. Sounds great, except 88 overall is like the lowest overall you can get out of these Ruby cards. So that's like a quick sell price. Jonathan Huberdeau. After the video, I was able to sell him for about 15K. So I guess I got my money back with this pack. Maybe lost a little bit. But it's better than getting 10 base cards like I did before. Let's open up some more because we haven't had enough disappointment in our lives. Let's see what we got here. Another Ruby card, John Gibson, also quick sell price, and that's it. Well, that's 2 really bad packs and 1 kind of average pack. Let's keep riding this train. 92 overall, Jonathan Marchessault, doing wonders for the Golden Knights right now. Goes for about 30K, so that is a decent pull out of this pack. But wait, there is more. As we also end up pulling 2 legend cards out of this. Koivu, Robitaille, I think they go for about 10 to 20k each at this point. Probably worse with the Ruby set. So for 40k, I'd say this was a pretty good pack. I think that 88 overall James Benn doesn't even go for anything now, so let's get rid of him. The four gold collectibles to a random Ruby player. Let's open up that up next. A 94 overall Taylor Hall. Now that is a pretty damn good pull that we spent four gold collectibles for. He's got a lot of maxed out or near maxed out stats in skating and shooting. I sold him for about 120k. Right after the video. Our pack openings will not end, as I have a bunch of ultimate pack that I bought during the All-Star game promotion, and then a League Cup playoffs pack that we're not going to open right now. So 40 gold rare players coming at you all at once. We're going to open up all these packs, see what's inside. A bunch of gold rare players. Okay, a little better towards the end. Connor McDavid, Torey Krug, Granlund, a best of 92 overall team of the week, Matthew Tkachuk, and a Draisaitl. A lot of cards that go from anywhere between about 20 to 50k. Can't remember the cost of the pack, but I think that these are pretty decent pulls. This is a pretty decent pack. Making sure I didn't miss anything back here, because this is a lot of cards to go through. Let's keep opening them for your viewing pleasure. More base cards started off. Patrick Kane, 88 overall. That's quick sell value. Team of the week, Leonard, 86 overall. Yeah, that's garbage. Ivo Pavelski, all right, that's pretty decent, but I'm guessing the value of his card is going to go down now that all these Ruby cards are way better than him. These cards probably don't make up the cost of the ultimate pack, but that's okay. We still get 20k free coins out of it. Onto the rare players pack, 20 gold rare players. Brock Besser, 93 overall. That is a really good pull. 92 overall. Radulov right next to him, also really good. The people love themselves some Besser, and I was able to sell him for about 200k. Radulov, I think, closer to 50k. Another 40 player pack. We get the 91 overall Jesse Pool Party flash forward card, and then a whole bunch of gold rare bases, which are all quick sells. Quick sell Gibson also shows his face towards the end. But yeah, that was a devastatingly bad pack. Two more to go. Up next, 88 overall quick sell Hutton. Legend Boyle for probably under 20k. David Perron, pretty decent. Gostisbehere, also pretty decent. Another Hoopy Dooby Doo, 88 overall Nylander. The cheat code Ben Bishop, 91 overall for about 50k. And 92 overall Suter, whose evolution card got an upgrade. Last pack of the night that we're going to open up and see what's inside. Starting things off, a lot of gold base cards again, but then 94 evolution card Connor Hellebuck appears, who goes for about 250k, making this pack worth it despite all these gold rare cards that are absolute garbage. The other thing that comes out is competitive seasons for the next 2 weeks, ends February 16th. The rewards for this include 96 overall exclusive Ruby cards, McKinnon, Kucherov, and Burns. In addition, you get a lot of player packs to go along with that. Again, you have to finish in the top 100 of the season or the round to get those exclusive cards. Top 3,000 get rare player packs just filled with those gold rare players. As promised, here are the list of all the players that received upgrades, their overalls, and the synergies that are included. This is brought to you by Reddit user Against the Current. So thank you for that. If you guys want to find out about this information before I can tell it to you, make sure you guys are members of this HUT community, which there's a link in the description below if you want to join it. So let's just go through it real quickly. You can stop if you want it to stop. This is going to be by teams. So it starts from Anaheim up top. It's going to end with Winnipeg on the bottom. Where you see Master Set Player MSP, what he meant to say was it's a competitive seasons reward, as we talked about it earlier in the video. They're not really master set players, but there's only going to be 100 of them, and they are tradable if you want to get them by the end of competitive seasons, or at the end of competitive seasons, I should say. With that said, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you found the videos informative, and again, stay tuned for the upcoming videos that could help you guys out in building your team with these Ruby cards.